إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Only praise due to Allah, we praise Him and we seek the help only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide Him, and whomever misguide, no one will guide Him. I be witness and testify, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty, and Muhammad is the last and final messenger. Alhamdulillah, we still in the series of As-Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, the companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and we still talking about the fourth Khalifa, Khalifa of Al-Muslimin, Ali radiyallahu anhu wa ardah, karramallahu wajhah. That Sahabi is one of the greatest Sahaba radiyallahu anhum, the cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the one he never did sujood to any idols or statue. The one, he is the first person become Muslim among of the teenagers. Ali radiyallahu anhu. And we spoke about his khilafah last class, and also we talk about that group, the evil sect, Al-Khawarij. Those group which they have bad ideas and bad faith. Those group, they are the reason behind the killing of Ali radiyallahu anhu. Those group, as we spoke about them, they have some bad faith, such as any person commit major sin, they say about him, he's out of Islam, he's kafir. And they translate the Quran according to their desire, and they twist the meaning of the Quran, and they raise up Ali radiallahu anhu, and they claim that Ali radiallahu anhu, he did not put the Quran as a law of Allah, and he chose two among of the Sahaba as a judge, not the Quran. Because when the misunderstanding each other between Muawiyah radiallahu anhu and Ali radiallahu anhu, so, and they have some khilaf, they have different opinion, so Ali radiallahu anhu choose, other than to continue fight or for the khilafah, choose Amr ibn al-As, okay, and another sahabi to be as a judge in this situation. So the Khawaj said that Ali radiallahu anhu and Muawiyah did not choose the Quran as a judge. That's how they twist the meaning, wal'a'adhu billah. And they says, whomever not put the Quran as a law of Allah, he's a kafir, he's out of Islam. So Ali radiallahu anhu is kafir, Muawiyah radiallahu anhu is kafir. So both of them should killed, and we should be killed and get out from them. So when the wal'adhu billah, they were around 6,000, so they start this spreading the idea, the evil idea about takfir. They extremely, they say about the Sahaba, the great Sahaba, they are kuffar. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, also the cousin of Rasulullah, decided to go and talk to them. Then Ibn Abbas, when he went to them, and they were 6,000, he said, Ali radiallahu anhu, give me a chance, because I'm worried about you from them. Then he went in the middle of the day, and he give them salam. He said, Marhaban bika ya Ibn Abbas. And they know him, Ibn Abbas, one of the best Sahaba. He's a cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, قلت لهم أتيتكم من عندي أصحاب رسول الله. I came to you from the companion of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and from the cousin Ali radiallahu anhu, Sihru, يعني the one he married, his daughter, we call Sihr. The Quran revealed upon those Sahaba, and they are the most knowledgeable in the ta'wil, in the meaning and explanation of the Quran. Tell me, why you are against of Sahaba? رضي الله عنه. Why you hate the cousin of Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم? They said because of three things. First of all, he chose a man as a judge, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, إن الحكم إلا لله. The حكم, the law, the principles should be belong to Allah. So why he chose the people, not the Quran? This is the first reason. Second one, he fought Muawiyah رضي الله عنه and Aisha when she went to make a sulh, to make a peace between the two groups. So Ali رضي الله عنه, according to what they believe, fought Muawiyah, but he did not take any ship or any things after the battlefield. Usually when there's a fight between non-Muslim and Muslim sometimes, okay, whatever left over from their sheep, from their weapon, it's become غنائم. We call it غنائم. Okay, الأنفال. Alright? So Ali رضي الله عنه, he did not take any from this. Number two. He did not take anything. He fought them, but he did not take anything from them. He fought them, but he did not take anything from them. So, if he fight them, they must be kuffar. So if they are kuffar, why he did not take from them? Yani he has two reasons. Maybe if he believe they are kuffar, he should take from them. If he does not believe they are kuffar, he should not fight them. Okay, so in the both side, that's how they translate. And he stopped being called Amir al-Mu'mineen, the prince of the believer. So what is mean that he will be Amir of al-Kafirin? He will be a prince of kuffar. That's how their mind and their brain interpret.
He stopped using the term
of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Okay. They said, "Do you have other than that?" He said, "That's enough for us three reasons against Ali radiallahu anhu." طيب, he said, "If I read the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallam over you, are you pleased? Do you accept it?" He said, "Yes, we accept the Quran, we accept the Sunnah." He said, "First of all, by saying he chose as a man to be a judge, not the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa taala." Said to us in Surah Al-Ma'idah, "Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la taqtulu as-sayda wa antum hurum." Oh, who believe, don't kill or hunt while you have ihram, while you are traveling for ihram. وَمَنْ قَتَلَهُ and whomever did this mutaammidan with attention, فَجَزَاءٌ مِثْلُ يعني جزاء, he has to sacrifice, he has to do something. مِثْلُ مَا قَتَلَ مِنَ النَّعَمِ same what he killed, he has to pay or whatever. يحكم به ذوى عدل منكم. Who give the حكم? ذوى عدل. Who is really honest? He will be a judge for his what he did. So Allah says, for something hunting, you can use justice people to give the judge against who did this wrong. So how about the Ali رضي الله عنه, he choose among of the best of the Sahaba to be a judge to solve the same things. Of course, they use the Quran, the two Sahaba, they use the Quran in this situation. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking us to choose two justice person, okay, احكم به ذوى عدل منكم, who they are just, in arnab, in rabbit, or in animal, they hunt. So how about something major? This is something major. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to use the justice people to give the hukum. To clarify, so something about arnab, rabbit, or a small animal that he hunt during the ihram. So how about something big, major? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also declared in the Quran, وَإِنْ خِفْتُمْ شِقَاقَ بَيْنِهِمَا فَابْعَثُوا حَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهِ وَحَكَمًا مِنْ أَهْلِهَا. If you are fear, between the husband and wife, they will be shiqaq, they will be split or divorced, whatever. So choose hakam, somebody wise from her family and wise from your family. إِنْ يُرِيدَ إِصْلَاحَ يُوَفِّقِ اللَّهُ بَيْنَهُمَا. Okay? So, حُكُم الرِّجَال فِي صَلَاحِ ذَاتِ مِنْ. We can choose the men to solve the issues and problem and solve the matter. Okay? better than increase. And by saying he fought and he did not take the ghanaim, the sheep, whatever left over after the battlefield, how come he take from your mother Aisha radiallahu anha? Because she went to the Muawiyah to solve the issue, and the fought start while she's Aisha radiallahu anha with a group of Muawiyah. Subhanallah, that fought, and how it's happened, as I said last time, the group of munafiqeen, they came in the night and they fight Ali radiallahu anha and his group, and in the same group they went and fought Muawiyah radiallahu anhu and his group. Then the morning everybody believe that Ali radiallahu anhu and his army attack us, and Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, Ali radiallahu anhu, he thought Muawiyah and his attack us, so it create the fitna. Those group of hypocrites, li'adhu billah. Then so how come you take from your mother? She is your mother, our mother Aisha radiallahu anha. And if you said she is not our mother, you are disbelieving the Quran. Allah says in the Quran, "An-nabiyyu awla bil mu'minina min anfusihim wa azwajuhu ummahatuhum." Allah said in Surah Al-Ahzab, "An-nabiyyu, the prophet of Allah, awla bil mu'minin, the most beloved, has more right over the believer than themselves. وَأَزْوَاجُهُ and his wife, أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ, their mother." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clear in the ayah, the wives of Rasulullah is the mother of the believer. So if you said, Aisha, she is not our mother, you deny the Quran. You disbelieve in the Quran. Subhanallah, look Ibn Abbas, how wise and how strong in knowledge to clarify this misconception. Then, subhanAllah, this is wrong. Then he said, okay. Then by saying, he delete the terminology or saying Amir al-Mu'mineen. I will tell you about Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, in the pledge of al-Hudaybiyah. صالح المشركين فقال لعلي, يعني الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, he did a pledge with a disbeliever. With a disbeliever, with a Quraysh, sulh, peace, and agreement. And he said to Ali رضي الله عنه, he said to Ali, write, هذا ما صالح عليه محمد رسول الله. This is what Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم did the pledge with محمد رسول الله. Muhammad, the messenger of Allah. Then the mushrikeen said, no, والله ما by the name of Allah, we don't know you are the prophet of Allah. Delete, O Ali. Delete Rasulullah. If we knew that you are Rasulullah, then we should obey you. We should follow you. But we don't believe. So delete Muhammad. Say, Salaha Muhammadun, without Rasulullah. And Ali radiallahu anhu, he deleted. And Rasulullah, he's better than Ali. And he accepted Nabi Sallallahu to delete Rasulullah in this situation. So Ali radiallahu an decide to delete because there is a situation now. There is no clarification. يعني. Subhanallah, there is a fitna going on. Subhanallah. Then 2,000 come out from that group after Ibn Abbas talked to them. Alhamdulillah. يعني. So far, it came back to the sunnah and come out from this bad manners or bad understanding, evil. Sometimes, wallahi, sometimes a bad understanding or evil understanding, very, subhanallah, evil make the person extreme until, wal'adhu billah, he has a heart to kill his brother. And this is really haram and major sin.
Ustaz, this Khawarij, which region were they from? Are they Iraqis or you know, Egypt area? No, which area?
The Muslim land, it was expand. So who accept this idea? It will be combined from. It can be. They was, subhanallah, some of the who established some ideas. I think I mentioned one of the name, but subhanallah, now I forgot. some of the main people, but one of them, very famous now, we're going to talk about him, the one he killed Ali radiallahu anhu. Okay, now we're going through. Okay. Then, what is happening? Those Khawarij, they kept that hatred against Ali radiallahu anhu, and Muawiyah, and Amr ibn al-As, and who been choosing to be a judge, all of them, they keep that hatred. So, Ali radiallahu anhu fought them, fought the Khawarij, because they're creating so much a problem. And he went over them in the battlefield called Nahrawan. Nahrawan, and he, subhanallah, kicked them out. Because they have a gathering and they want to fight Ali radiallahu anhu. So Ali radiallahu anhu fought them back and he went over them in the battlefield they call Nahrawan. Then they kept that hatred to kill Ali radiallahu anhu. Okay? So, who decide this? Abdurrahman bin Muljim al-Khariji. One person, his name Abdurrahman bin Muljim al-Khariji. Subhanallah, he decided to kill Ali radiallahu anhu. And how did this happen? He went and he bought a sword, very good sword, and he went shop by shop asking, how this is my sword? The experienced people, one person he said, you should make sharp, band, do this, this. Whatever the experienced people told him to do, he did in his that sword. And that is not enough. He put his sword with the poison 40 days. And until the what you call the iron absorbed the poison. Look how, wal'adhu billah, hatred that person. Then he went, and Ali radiallahu anhu, everybody know, he go to Salatul Fajr, okay, and he's the Amir of al-Mu'mineen, he's the Prince of the Believer, but he go without security guard. And he go before Fajr early to walk to the masjid and wake up the people. قوموا إلى الفجر, قوموا إلى الصلاة, wake up for Salah, wake up for Fajr. This is the way of Ali radiallahu anhu doing. Subhanallah. Then he came suddenly behind Ali radiallahu anhu and he hit him in his neck.
While Ali was praying?
No, he is walking. In the darkness without security, he came, subhanallah, behind and he hit him, wal'adhu billah, and he started bleeding immediately and went conscious. The Sahaba, they follow up this person until they caught him. Abdurrahman bin Miljim, they caught him and they sent Ali radiallahu anhu home, subhanallah, because he was conscious. After that, he wake up Ali radiallahu anhu and he asked who did, and they brought him Abdurrahman bin Miljim. And all the family of Ali radiallahu anhu and children and the family, they look at the Abdurrahman bin Miljim, how evil they kill the father, they kill our the Amir al-Mu'mineen, and subhanallah, they look at their eyes to over Abdurrahman bin Miljim, in they want to revenge. Then look at Ali radiallahu anhu, even in this situation, he said, listen, if I don't die, leave the person, it's up to me, I can forgive or I can ask for revenge, subhanallah. If I died, be good and kind to him, only apply the law of Allah. And subhanallah, the Ali radiallahu anhu, for following day, he passed away. Ali radiallahu anhu, he asked Abdurrahman bin Miljim. He said, oh Abdurrahman, why you did this? Last time I was very kind to you, I did very good towards you. I was good towards you, you, subhanallah, oh Abdurrahman. And Abdurrahman, he said, yes, he was good. And he said, so why you have the heart to kill me? What the reason? He said, I think, look here, please understand what he said. Abdurrahman bin Maljim, قبحه الله, subhanallah, that evil mind, evil brain, subhanallah, he said, I prepared that sword for well prepared, and I put it inside the poison for 40 days. And every morning I ask Allah, oh Allah, let me kill with this sword the most evil person. He asked Allah. He think he's, mashallah, very religious, very wise. I ask Allah every day in the morning, oh Allah, let me kill the most evil person. And he think that Allah accepts his dua. That's what he thinking. Look, a bad mind. Then Ali radiallahu anhu, he look at him and he said, wallahi, Allah will kill you with the same sword. You will be among of the most evil people. And subhanAllah, later on, he being killed by the same sword. He asked Allah to be killed the worst of the people. And he did dua to Allah, oh Allah, let me use that sword to kill the most evil person. And Ali radiallahu anhu replied back to him, you will be among, he did not say you are the worst. Look at Ali radiallahu anhu, even wise when he replied, you will be among of the worst of the people. Because Allah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he promised the paradise for Ali radiallahu anhu. Cannot be. He's a believer, he's a good, he's an Amir al-Mu'mineen. And subhanAllah, they used the sword to do the qisas over Abdurrahman bin Miljin, and he be killed with the same sword he prepared, and he asked Allah, La ilaha illallah. Can you imagine, yani, the things, how it happened? SubhanAllah. Teaching us a lesson that sometimes you think you are right, you are doing right, and you end up, you are the wrong and you are the evil. We have to, whatever we're doing, we put it in the scale of Al-Quran and Sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. No, in Medina. Yeah. And subhanAllah, he died in the 7th of Ramadan. It was Ramadan. And not only this, the Khawarij prepared one person to go and kill Amr ibn al-As. And one person kill Muawiyah.
Muawiyah escaped.
And Amr ibn al-As, Allah saved them, subhanAllah, for the somehow. How it happened? Amr ibn al-As, he was the Amir of the city where he was. When the person, they told him, go and kill, because they knew that the Amir, he's the leader of the Salah. So in that time, in the morning, Amr ibn al-As, he was very sick, and he asked Kharija to be Imam. So the person, he doesn't know Amr ibn al-As. He knew that the Amir al-Mu'mineen, he will be the Imam. Then he went and he stabbed Kharija and he killed him. When they brought the killer and put him, and Amr ibn al-As, he came to the place and say, Assalamu alaikum Amir al-Mu'mineen, everybody give salam to Amir al-Mu'mineen. The guy, he realized he killed the wrong person. SubhanAllah. The person he went, send him to kill Muawiyah bin Abi Sufyan, he was a big, mashallah, tall and strong. He mistakenly hit him, but he did not hit the neck, he hit his foot, below his foot, and hit his sexual part. And after that, Muawiyah, he couldn't get any child. He cannot get any child. And he hit him from area, he, SubhanAllah, spoil his male, SubhanAllah. Only had the child, that's why Amawi, he has had one child before that happened, Yazid. SubhanAllah. So those is the Khawarij, they plan to kill all those and spread the corruption between the Adi, because they have a deep, bad understanding, SubhanAllah, and influence in the Quran and Sunnah. SubhanAllah. That is how the death of Ali radiallahu anhu, may Allah subhanahu gather us with him in Jannah. Ameen, ameen. Radiallahu anhu. He is shaheed of al-Ummah, and he was of the best of the Sahaba radiallahu anhu.
So Ali was in Kufa when he was meeting with Aisha. Then he came back after.
This is afterwards, because they choose to delay until Ramadan and choose to judge. This is, there's many things happen during that time. Subhanallah. So that's Ali radiallahu anhu. He was Khalifa radiallahu anhu. This is how he became Shaheed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shall accept his Shahada. And he was justice and he was a great among of the Sahaba. Let's go to the sum of the advices of Ali radiallahu anhu.
Five years.
Ali radiallahu anhu, he was very famous in wisdom. And he's very good in giving advices. Let's go through some of his advices. And we are not allowed to curse any kind of Sahaba. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, as we said last week, لا تسبوا أحدا من أصحابي. Don't curse anyone among of my companions. And another hadith, and this authentic. قال الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم, من سب أصحابي فعليه لعنة الله والملائكة والناس أجمعين. Whomever curse my companions, the curse of Allah over him and the angels and the all people. So we not allowed to curse any kind of Sahabi, whomever he is, even if we believe he make mistake. قال الإمام الطحاوي, is very good saying, في العقيدة, ونحب أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We love the companion of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولا نفرط في حب أحد منهم. And we will not allow to be extremely in our love to any one of them, extremely over, you know. ولا نتبرأ من أحد. And we are not have a right to say any one of them he is not part of us. Mean براءة, نتبرأ. Okay. And we not allowed to hate any one of them. And we should always mention them in good all the time. Love them is a part of deen. Iman wa ihsan. Hate them is kufr wa nifaq wa tughyan. Hate them is a part of disbelief and hypocrisy and wrongdoing. And we believe the khilafah after Rasulullah sallam firstly to Abu Bakr Siddiq without any doubt. And second, Umar bin Khattab. And the third, Uthman bin Affan. And the fourth is Ali radiallahu anhu. And who all they are? Khulafa al-Rashidin, the guided Khalifa. And al-Imma al-Mahdiyun, the guided Imams. Radiallahu anhu. That's what Imam al-Tahawi in his kitab, Al-Aqidah, is very famous. Al-Aqidah al-Tahawiyya. If we want to refer something in Aqidah, his book is one of the famous reference. They call Al-Aqidah al-Tahawiyya in his book. Some of the advices, subhanallah, he advised a lot, Ali radiallahu anhu, to be aware from the fitna of ad-dunya. Be aware from the fitna of the dunya. One time he been asked, oh Ali, safna ad-dunya, describe to us the dunya. He said, ma asifu min darin awwaluha ana. What I can describe for you from the dunya? That house in the beginning is ana, tiring. وآخرها فناء, and the end of the dunya, death. If we take the lawful one, we will be cushion, hisab. And if we do the haram, we will be punished. Whomever استغنى بها, whomever he rich with the dunya, he will be in fitna. And whomever be away from dunya, he will be in poorness and he will feel sad. Yani he is saying the dunya is wherever you go, this way, this way, this way, always trouble. You know, always trouble. So that don't think about it. Think about akhir. In other way. Subhanallah. If you are rich from the dunya, you will be in fitna. If you are poor from the dunya, you will be sad feeling. If you beginning of the dunya is tiring, end of the dunya death. Yani, subhanallah, what is this dunya we are grieving for? That's what Ali radiallahu anhu described. Wasu'ila, and he asked another question. Tell us about dunya. Then he asked him, shall I talk long speech or short speech? They asked him short speech. He said, if short speech, حلالها حساب. The lawful from the dunya will be questioned about it. وحرامها عذاب, will be punished. فدعوا الحلال لطول الحساب. Leave the lawful, the one, يعني سبحان الله, يعني you, is not necessary to take. Leave it. So you will not be questioned. And leave the haram, so you will not be punished. In other way, يعني, don't be fight for the dunya. Don't compete the dunya. Take what you need from the dunya, that's it. Subhan, that's what he, other way he said. So because if you take so much from the dunya, it will be more question in Yawm al-Akhir. That's what he referred. And the hadith of Rasulullah sallam, he maybe take this some advice from some hadith. Rasulullah sallam, he said, قمت على باب الجنة فكان عامة من دخلها المساكين. I stood up over the door of the Jannah. Rasulullah said, I saw the most people in Jannah is al-masakin, the poor. Subhanallah. Al-fuqara wa ashab al-jadd, and the rich people, the one he is lucky, they are rich, mahbusun, they will be subhanallah left over, they remain for the judge. But the people of the hellfire, they've been ordered to be dragged to the hellfire, wal-iyadu billah. So this is what you call extra creditation and virtue for the poor Muslim who is really poor. Don't think, oh, I am poor, look at the rich, I enjoy their life. At least if you die in Iman or something, the people of the masakin, they will be entered before the rich people. Yeah, you have also accreditation. SubhanAllah. And there's another hadith, يدخل الفقراء الجنة قبل الأغنياء بخمسمائة عام. The rich people, the poor people, they will enter the Jannah before the rich people 500 years. SubhanAllah. And this is a hadith, رواه الترمذي وابن ماجة ومصنف ابن شيبة والمعجم الأوسط الطبراني ومسند الإمام أحمد. والحديث قال عنه الشيخ الألباني, حديث حسن صحيح. So حديث صحيح. 500 years. Allahu Akbar. 500 years is not small time. SubhanAllah. يعني the rich, he enjoy 60 years, but the miskin, he enter 500 before him. SubhanAllah. So you shouldn't regret if you are among of the poor people. If Allah wrote you are poor, be patient. طيب. علي رضي الله عنه other advice. قال الدنيا جيفة. من أرادها فليصبر على مخالطة الكلاب. We should write as a hikmah. Wiz. Why? So much wise word. Short, very deep. الدنيا جيفة. الدنيا is like a dead animal. جيفة. جيفة means dead animal. من أرادها, whomever wanted, he has to be patient to mix up with the dogs. الدنيا جيفة. الدنيا is like dead animal. Whomever wanted, he has to be patient to mix up with the dogs. Who fight for the dead animal? Dogs.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. He has to be, if I want the dunya, I have to be patient over to mix up with all kind of dogs. Because all of them fighting for it.
Mix with the low life.
Low life. That's what he want to tell us. And he may be absorbed from the hadith of Rasulullah الدنيا ملعونة. الدنيا being cursed by Allah. ملعون ما فيها. Everything being cursed in the dunya except ذكر الله. Remembering Allah. وما ولا and everything belong to this. وعالما and knowledgeable. ومتعلما a person seeking knowledge. Those will be have exception from the cursing of Allah. So we should be among of the remembering Allah and seeking knowledge and teaching knowledge. Inshallah. So you'll be not part of this. Another advices. One time Ali radiallahu anhu, he gave khutbah. He said, Ala ayyuhan nas, O people, innama ad-dunya, indeed, ad-dunya aradun hadir. It's just a temporary. يأكل منها البر والفاجر. The good and the bad, both of them they eat from the dunya. وإن الآخرة وعد صادق. The akhirah is truly promised. يحكم فيها الملك القادر. who give the charge in the Akhirah? Allah, Al-Malik, the King, Al-Qadir, that have a power, have ability. أَلَا إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَعِيدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ Shaitan promise you the poorness. وَيَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ and order you to do bad. قال تعالى وَاللَّهُ يَعِيدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِّنْهُ وَفَضْلًا Allah promised you مَغْفِرَة, forgiveness, وَفَضْلًا فَضْل, the bounty, the ni'mah, the jannah, and وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعُ الْعَلِيمُ. He is telling us, don't grieve for dunya. Don't fight for the dunya. Don't look for dunya. Don't think all the time about dunya. Because the dunya is nothing, is a trash, will be perished. Subhanallah. That's what most of his advice. Then he continued, in the khutbah, mashallah, even in Arabic, so high Arabic, mashallah, Ali radiallahu anhu, one of the most best speaker among the Sahaba, in the public speaking. قال أحسنوا في أعماركم, do good in your lifetime. تحفظوا في أعقابكم, you will be saved later on. فإن الله وعد جنته من أطاعه, Allah promised the Jannah to whomever he obey Allah. He obey Allah. وَأَوْعَدَ نَارَهُ مَنْ عَصَاهُ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised the punishment and the hell whomever disobey Allah. إِنَّهَا نَارٌ لَا يَهْدَأُ زَفِيرُهَا It's a hellfire. Will not relax at all. وَلَا يُفَكُّ أَسِيرُهَا That hellfire whomever taken as a hostage, he will not be released. وَلَا يُجْبَرُ كَسِيرُهَا حَرُّهَا شَدِيدٌ It's very hot. وقعرها بعيد and very deep وماءها صديد and the water is like وَالْعَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ صديد it's dirty وَإِنَّ أَخْوَفَ مَا أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ and I am the most fear over you to follow الْهَوَى your desires and you have a long hope long thinking about long life just always thinking I have long life I have to do for dunya فَإِنَّ اتِّبَاعَ الْهَوَى follow your desire, they will be abandoned you from the حق. يَصُدُّ عَلْ حَقِّ وَإِنَّ طُولَ الْأَمَلْ يُنْسِ الْآخِرَةِ And thinking about long life will make you forget the akhirah. So two diseases. You talk about follow the desire, that's abandoning you from the truth. And have a thinking about long life all the time, make you forget the akhirah. And he said, continue. إن الزاهدين في الدنيا اتخذوا الأرض بساطة هو الزاهد الزاهد سبحان الله I don't know which is the best word in English to find الزاهد زاهد أو الزهد is one of the character one of the quality is make the person banded the dunya from his heart banded the materialistic material from the dunya that means زاهد whom ban the dunya, they take the ground as a bed and the sand as a as a bed والماء طيبا and the water إلا من اشتاق إلى الآخرة سلع عن الشهوان whomever desire for آخرة he will be away and banned himself from the desires ومن أشفق من النار and whomever fear the hell and the nar and the fire He will be abandon himself from muharramat, from haram. And whomever want the Jannah, he will be speed up by doing the ta'at, the good deeds. وَمَنْ زَهَدَ فِي الدُّنْيَا هَانَتْ عَلَيْهِ الْمَصَائِبِ And whomever banned the dunya from his heart, all the calamity, all the problem, all the musibah become easy upon him. Soft, because dunya is nothing. Whatever the musibah it is, dunya is only temporary. So will whatever happened to him is, subhanallah, will not make him feel tired or worried. Also Ali radiallahu anhu, inshallah, last advice, we do go, try to finish, inshallah. مَوَاعِظُهُ فِي الْمَوْتِ وَمَا بَعْدَ الْمَوْتِ He also advised about the death and after the death. أمير علي رضي الله عنه يذكر الناس بالموت وما بعد الموت he remind the people one of the advice he said أيها الله الغار بنفسه oh who enjoying and he think about himself he's really good he's good enough as he guaranteed the Jannah for him as I feel, وقد أتاك رسول ربك, I feel that the messenger of Allah came to you, is not coming to knock to your door, but he's coming, subhanallah, take your soul. He will not have mercy if you are a small or big. If it's written, your life will be, he is ordered to take it. Where they are those who speed up and strive and strive and struggle for dunya? Where they are who collect and he accounts? Where they are the one they built and make decoration for his building? Where they are those he will not accept the little, and he will not say enough from enjoyment by the so much, taking so much? Where they are who lead the armies? Who, where they are نشر البنود, who put and establish the rules and law? All of them, they came and they died. They are under the ground, and they drank the water of the death. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّكَ لَمَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَمَيِّتُونَ. Indeed, you will be a die, subhanahu wa Muhammad, you will die, and they going to die, all the people. And Jibreel alayhi salam, he said, يَا مُحَمَّدْ عِشْ مَا شِئْتَ فَإِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ. Live as much you want, surely you will die. Subhanallah. وكأن عمر رضي الله عنه يقول لا شيء, and he said a very long poem, subhanallah. He has long advice. This is part of it, inshallah. And one of his poem, very famous, it's called ليس الغريب غريب الشام واليمني إن الغريب غريب اللحد والكفني. He wrote it, Ali radiallahu anhu, amazing poem to make reflect your mind about ban the dunya from your heart. He said, not the strange who is from Yemen or Sham, from Syria, is coming from strange country. No, the really strange person, he is in the grave. When he leave the dunya, he will be alone. Subhanallah, hadi wal kafani, inna al ghariba lahu haqqu li ghurbat. And he said, my travel is very long journey, and what I took is not enough. Subhanallah, look at, he's the best of the Sahaba, and also he humble himself. Subhanallah, always blaming himself. How about us? So we should always blaming ourselves, humble ourselves, think about Akhirah, subhanallah. Last, inshallah, here, Qala Ali radiallahu anhu, last one. So we finish the story of Ali radiallahu anhu, then we can start next week by the new Sahabi. Qala Ali, man jama'a sitta khisal, لم يدع للجنة مطلبا ولا عن النار مهربا. Whomever have a six qualities or six attributes or six characters, first, من عرف الله فأطاعه. Whomever person, he know Allah and he obey him. This is the first one. وَعَرَفَ الشَّيْطَانَ فَعَصَىٰ. And he know the shaytan and he disobey the shaytan. Second one. وَعَرَفَ الْحَقَّ فَاتَّبَعُهُ. And he know the truth and he follow the truth. وَعَرَفَ الْبَاطِلَ فَاتَّقَاهُ. And he know the batil, the misconception, the batil, the wrong, untrue. فاتقاه, he abandoned him. وعرف الدنيا فرفض, and he knew the dunya and he kicked out from him. وعرف الآخرة فطلبها, and he knew the آخرة and he strive for it. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه, وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. اللهم اجمعنا مع الصحابة. اللهم إنا نشهد أننا نحب صحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, فاجمعنا معهم في الجنة, ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا, ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا واجعل الجنة دارنا وقرارنا آمين يا أرحم الراحمين. Shall now the question for 1-2 minutes if you have. Yes, sister.
So you say six characters. One
yes.
Knows Allah and obey him.
Yes.
Knows the truth and
no shaytan and disobey him. The second one. Yeah. وعرف الشيطان فعصاه. وعرف الحق فاتبعه. وعرف الباطل فاتقاه. وعرف الدنيا فرفضها. وعرف الآخرة فطلبها.
He knows dunya, so he.
وعرف الدنيا فرفضها. He kicked away. He banned the dunya. Kicked away from him. He rejected. Sorry. فرفضها is more rejected. He rejected the dunya. Inshallah. Any other question? Inshallah. سبحان الله وبحمده. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأتوب إليك. صلى الله عليه وسلم.